Alright, so real quick, what we're going to look at is doing these transformations as far as... Tyler, can you go back to my desk real quick? I need your help for something here in just a bit. We're going to look at transformations, and I'm going to start by showing you that the blue graph is this one, the green graph is this one, and the red one is this one right here. Now, looking at the blue graph, what's the parent function, guys? What's the parent function for all of these three?
The dotted one.
The dotted one, which is y equals the square root of x. We know fundamentally our graph starts here. Okay? What's the transformation in blue? Anyone that you see? This 4 times x business inside the square root, what would be horizontal or vertical?
Horizontal.
Horizontal, yes. Because if you don't know it already, horizontal is going to be inside with the x, vertical is going to be outside with y. So it's a horizontal compression by 1/4. Okay? The red one is a horizontal
stretch
by 3 because you flip that reciprocal. And then the third one has 2 transformations. Vanya, what's the first transformation that the green one has? It says square root of negative 3 times x. Yeah, horizontal. Not a compression. He says a compression because negative 3 looks less than 1, but what he should... Well, we're going to flip it, but we got to look at negative 3 as 2 separate transformations. Lauren, which one's the first one?
The reflection over the y-axis.
There you go. Reflection across the y-axis is the negative. Pal, what's the next one? Compression by 1/3. Nice. Y'all see what we're doing? These are just showing the transformations as far as you guys are good with transformations like with square root, or sorry, with absolute value and like x squared. And I just want to make sure that you're good to go with this as well. Look at this function right here. Okay? So Tyler's back there and he's going to help me out. And we're going to discuss what are the transformations as we go through the problem that you see with Desmos. All right, so Tyler, right here what I want you to do is I want you to go ahead and put right here negative 1/2 times the square root, and it's down here, times this, okay, the square root of x minus 3, and then kick out. So let's take away this parentheses. You don't need that. And then out here, we're going to kick out, and we're going to put plus 1. Now look at this graph. Our graph is to get to this red graph right here. And we're going to get there from the original parent function. And what's a parent function? Square root of x. So put square root of x. Okay, so we're at blue, and we're trying to get to red. And let's do it in order. Ask them, what's the first one? Okay, horizontal shift to the right 3. So just control A, control C. And then control V. And now put inside, I want you to put minus 3. And sure enough, the green shows what Ashlyn just said. It's a horizontal translation or shift 3 to the right. Okay? Grant, what's the new? So control A, control C. What's the new transformation in order? Okay, here we go. So control V to paste it, put the negative out front, and Grant says this will change it to a reflection. Yes, from green, we reflected across from the running answer. Now our running answer is what's in purple. Control A, control C. And then over here, control V. Okay, so put that negative right there. Okay, so from that purple, we have 2 more transformations. Fernandez, what's the next one?
Vertical compression by
1/2. Put 1/2 right there. Let's see if that thing compresses vertically. Sure enough, it did. So now our running answer is the black graph. Okay? So control A, control C, control V. From here, Michelle, what's our last one?
Vertical shift up 3.
Vertical shift up. Wait, what?
Up 3, right?
Only up.
I can't.
Chill. No worries. Up one. Up one. All right, so we're going from this equation up here. And sure enough, red landed on red. Okay? Now listen. What I want you to finish today off with understanding how these transformations work is to use pivot points. The big pivot points that we chose today were the following. 0, 0, 1, 1. We used 4, 2. You could have also used 9, 3. Please don't put up yet, okay? So 4, 2, watch. If I chose 0, 0, now I'm going to go through this as a list. The first one you said was it shifted 3 to the what?
3.
Right. So it should have become 3, 0. Then it reflected across the x-axis, means the y value was multiplied with a negative 1. Nothing happened. Then it was vertically stretched by a factor of 1 half. You mean that means you multiply the y value of 0 by 1 half. Nothing happened. And last but not least, it was a vertical shift 1 unit what? Up, which would become 3, 1. So 0, 0 went all the way to 3, 1. You see what we're doing?
Yes.
We do that with all the points. We'll do one more. 4, 2. If 4, 2 starts as 4, 2 here, after this transformation, what does it become? Come on, guys. 3 shifted to the right. 7, 2. Reflected across the x-axis. 7, negative 2, because the y got a negative 1 multiplication. Now we're going to compress it. That means we're going to multiply the y value by a 1 half. What do you get? Yep. And then finally, you're going to shift it 1 unit up to get 7, 0. So 4, 2 went to 7, 0. That's all we got for today. Nice job. Hold on, let me pause this.